justified me.
Of his fullness have we all received of him.
I'm a new creation, I'm a brand new man. Old things have passed away, I'm a born again. More than a conqueror, that is who I am. I'm a new creation, I'm a brand new man. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we are new creation, glory be to God. Forever and forever, Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. Welcome, fellow believers, all of you, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Praise God. We give glory to the Father in the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm bringing to you again the gospel of peace, the gospel, the good news. Christ and him crucified, that is the wisdom that God could use to silence the principality and the powers, to redeem man from the crushes of the devil, and to redeem man from the curse of the law, from sickness, disease. Oh, glory be to God. Now we are more than conquerors because of what Jesus did on the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. Glory be to God forever and forever. Let me go to this scripture here in the book of Acts 8, the book of Acts 8, verse 4. The Bible says here that devout men, they carried Stephen and buried him, and also the great lamentation over him. For as Saul made havoc of the church, entering into every house, and also hailing men and women, committing them to the prison. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad, they went everywhere preaching the word of God. The Bible also talk about Philip, that the Philip preached Christ. When Philip went to Samaria, he preached the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, I've noticed in the last few years that the last 8 or 10 years, I've noticed now that so many pastors, they are preaching everything, but they are not preaching Jesus Christ and him crucified. In the last 50 years, or in the early 50s, 60s, 100s years, we were preaching the real gospel, Jesus Christ. There were ministers that were preaching the gospel, they were preaching Christ and him crucified. But the last few years has turned to something else, that people are preaching everything. The church, witchcraft has entered into the church has now become now like a counseling place. It has become now people are teaching philosophy, they are teaching different things that does not really matter, that cannot save any soul, but therefore they don't teach Jesus Christ and him crucified. And that is, the Bible says there is no other name under the heaven that any man can be saved, only in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Ministers, they are preaching, there were ministers before who preached the gospel. From time to time, Jesus Christ went to heaven until the last, they were preaching the gospel ultra until when the last 10 years now, they are preaching not the gospel of the cross again. They are preaching fellowship, they are preaching prayer. You will see churches are doing fellowship, prayer, dancing, night vigil, and they are not preaching the truth of the gospel. People, there are so many people inside the church today who are not saved, they are not healed, they are not delivered, because they don't know the truth. They are in the church, they are not even saved, because many people who are in the church, they think that they are saved. The devil is so, he is really, really tricky. The Bible talk about him in the book of Second Corinthians. Let me go to that scripture. That the devil is so tricky. He will even send now, these last days, his ministers them to become like the ministers of light. Will their end, it will be destruction. The Bible talk about the devil, how he is, we are not ignorant of his devices. He said here, and he said that for such are false apostles who are deceitful workers. They are transforming themselves unto the apostles of Jesus Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is now transformed unto the angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing that if his ministers also will be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their work. If you go to churches, you will see, I went to Finland, it was so amazing. Because I noticed that it was only one church or two churches that were, one in our Vale, who always teach about salvation and Jesus Christ and Him crucified. And then our church that was in Pori there, that church, that Pentecostal church, you know, that was the one was also teaching about Jesus Christ. Most of the other churches, they will even be doing communion. They are not teaching about Jesus Christ. They will be talking something about David. They'll be speaking something about the old covenant. But the gospel, it is the gospel that transforms man. The devil will want, the devil doesn't care. If you share food, if you are, you say you are a minister and you are sharing food for people, if you are visiting hospitals, if you are doing counseling for Christians, if you can do anything, you can preach anything, you can preach about marriage, preach about anything, but don't preach, the devil will be mad when you preach about Jesus Christ and Him crucified, because that is where the power is, the power to change man. The Bible says the gospel is the power of God to salvation to everyone that believe. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So I've noticed that everywhere. I don't know if you have noticed it too. So I'm just trying to make you to be aware. These people are deceitful workers who are transforming like an angel of light. All these ministers of the devil. They are not ministers of righteousness. They are ministers of the devil. They are of the evil works. Paul was speaking in Philippians. Say, beware of dogs. Beware of evil workers. So be careful, because the only the gospel of Jesus Christ can transform any human being. No dancing, no night vigil, no fasting, all those things does not really matter. Somebody, there's nobody that will be saved who has not heard the gospel. The book of Romans 10 was speaking there. Say, if you will believe in your heart and then believe in your heart that Jesus Christ that Jesus Christ is Lord, if you believe in your heart that Jesus died for your sin and you confess with your mouth that He was raised from the dead, and then you shall be saved. Then He was even keep continuing to say that whosoever believe in Him shall be saved. He talked about, but how can they believe in Him who they have no head? How can they hear without the preacher? How can they preach when they are not sent? So all those things, they matter, because if nobody He can be saved, we don't know the truth of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, what He did on Calvary, that He died for our sin and He was rose again. The word of God is so powerful. When we preach the simple truth, Jesus Christ died for you, if we tell them Jesus Christ was rose again for you, Jesus Christ is coming back for you, you tell them the gospel as simple as, say, God made Jesus to be sin for you, who knew no sin, so that you should be made now the righteousness of God in Him. So that is what changed people, and when they know the truth. So the preach, you see, the Bible says that Philip went to Samaria, he preached Christ. The devils were leaving the people. Miracles and signs and wonders took place in Samaria as Philip preached the Lord Jesus Christ. Preach Christ. The best thing I will advise you, preach Jesus Christ. Preach Christ and Him crucified. The gospel is not all what is in the Bible, because the whole Bible, the old, and there is a new covenant and there is the old covenant. So the old covenant was a types and shadow that was pointing to the Lord Jesus. But now we have the gospel. So preach the gospel, not preach the whole Bible, what is in the Bible, to people who are unbelievers. They will never be saved. That is my advice to anyone. Amen. Religion is not the gospel. Amen. But the good news, is the gospel. Only in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that only one name, there's only one name under heaven that we shall be saved. That is the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In Jesus' name. So let us start to be like Philip today, to preach Jesus Christ and Him crucified. You can preach simple things. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. You know, that whosoever believe in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The people have gone poor with Jesus Christ. The people who have gone poor with there are so many religions now in the world that you see they are teaching also other things, you know. They are teaching also different things, but you will never hear anyone teach about the cross. Amen. Other religion, they can preach anything under the air, but not Jesus Christ and not the cross, what was done on Calvary. You hear many people, they preach five keys is to get prosper, you know, 7 steps to make it in this world, to progress, all kind of stuff. But they don't preach Jesus Christ and Him crucified. When I say Jesus Christ and Him crucified, I'm talking about the Jesus Christ, the work that was done all on for salvation for the human race, that Jesus tested for all man. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, to bring many souls to glory. What was accomplished on Calvary? That is what Paul was speaking about, Jesus Christ and Him crucified. So that is why you see Philip went to Samaria, he preached Christ there, and there was miracle there. Amen. In the name of Jesus, healing and deliverance. God will not do anything. God will not do anything to anybody if He doesn't do it in the name of His Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. In Jesus' name. All other religion, they can preach any other thing, but not Jesus Christ. They can bring all, and the Bible says that only the preaching of the cross is what bring a permanent change in anybody's life. Amen. But many people are going to places today to go for quick fix. They want always quick fix. Oh, they do prayer all day and night, all kind of prayer. Oh, they go to the deliverance places where they will just bind and cast out the devil, and the devil will come back because you don't know the truth anyway, to close the door, you know. So there are so many things. People just want quick fix. They just want prayer. They want fasting. They say, okay, do me, and they just tell me anything that I can do now to get freedom. No, the Bible says you shall know the truth, and it is the truth that will make you free. The truth of the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ on Calvary. That is only what will make you free. The good news, good works will not help you. Prayer and fasting is okay to do when you know the truth. But you can do, but the other religion, they do fast. Other religion, they do pray. You will see all kind of religion, even the Muslim, the Eastern, you will see their fast, Ramadan, other things, but they are not saved. The Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Ghost asked me that in Finland one time. He said, you see the Muslim people, I say, yes, daddy. You say, you see how they fast, they pray, they wear hijab, they dress in holiness, they wash their hands, they wash their feet, they do circumcision, they do that. He said, do they know me? I said, no, daddy, they don't know you. They don't know God. They don't know the Holy Ghost. They don't know Jesus Christ. It's only when you believe the gospel, that is when you are given this inheritance, this free gift, the Holy Spirit, to come and start living now in you. Christ is in you. He is the hope of glory. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus. That is when you have that freedom. Prayer will not do it. Amen. Amen. Nobody in this world can be saved through prayer. You can pray that somebody will be saved, and then God will send somebody to that person who will tell them the gospel, and they can't be saved. They cannot be saved because they just pray for them. No, they must hear the gospel. Nobody can be saved without hearing the gospel. So that is the most important thing. So Philip went and preached Christ the gospel. The Bible says that even the apostle in the book of Mark 16, the Bible said the apostles, they went about preaching the word of God. Then the Bible said with signs and signs following. So the Holy Spirit, the Bible says that God will perform His word with signs following, because when He hear the word, the preachers, they are preaching the word, He now know when you believe it in your heart, and then now He now will now perform that science, perform that miracle. When you hear that Jesus Christ took your infirmity, bore your sickness on His own body, so that you should be dead to sin and live now unto righteousness by His wounds you were healed, and you believe that word in your heart, then from there, that is when God now give you the healing. That's just how it is. Amen. The Holy Spirit now will give you the healing. The Bible said the Holy Spirit performed miracles, signs, and wonders as the gospel was preached to the people. Amen. So that is just how it is. So Jesus Christ now have sent us. We have to go everywhere and preach the gospel, and as ambassadors of the Lord Jesus Christ, to reconcile God's people back to Himself. Let us be today like we are Philip, in the name of the Lord Jesus, to preach the Lord Jesus Christ, Christ and Him crucified, the gospel. The gospel is what saves people. If you go to churches, you see day and night people are preaching other things. They preach Daniel, they preach David, they preach other stuff. They don't relate it to the cross. They don't relate it to the work that was finished on the cross. Forget it. That is just a waste of time. Because the Bible speaks in the book of 1 Corinthians 1, verse 18. It says here that, no, in verse 17, Paul was speaking here, he said, for Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. For it is written that I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and I will bring to nothing also the understanding of the prudent. So where is the wise? Where is the prescribed? And where is the deputer of this world? Had God not made foolish the wisdom of this world? For after that, in wisdom, the world was with wisdom, knew no God. So it pleases God that by the foolishness of the preaching of the cross should save those who believe. For the Jews require science, and the Greek, they are seeking for wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified. Unto the Jews, it is a stumbling block, and unto the Greek, it is foolishness. But unto us who believe, unto you and I who believe, both the Jews and Greek, or the Gentiles, Christ is the power of God and the wisdom of God. Yes, preaching of the cross is the power of God. Amen. To anyone that believes, Christ is the power of God, and Christ is the wisdom of God to silence the principalities and the power, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We stay in a church, they are not preaching you the gospel. They are not teaching you what Jesus Christ did on the cross of Calvary. They are teaching you something, and forget it. I've seen so many people will talk everything in this world, talk different things in the old covenant, something, and say in Jesus' name. That is nothing. People do not, they need the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says the preaching of the cross, the gospel of God, it is the power of God. It is the power of God to save anyone that believe in the name of Jesus. So God bless you, brothers and sisters, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'll see you in the next audio, in the next video, in the name of Jesus Christ. I hope this strengthens you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is the power of God and the wisdom of God. So the preaching of the Lord Jesus Christ is the power of God in Jesus Christ. So Jesus is our burden bearer. Jesus Christ came to bore our burden in the name of Jesus, and our heavy laden in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Bible talk about Jesus Christ in the book of Matthew. He said, come, Jesus Christ will say, come unto me, all you that are heavy laden. You are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you peace. Yes, Jesus Christ wants to help us. He came to set the captives free. Amen. He will cast out devils only in the name of Jesus Christ. So cast your burden today, your heavy laden, upon Jesus, because Jesus Christ cares for you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He came to take away the garment of heaviness and to restore us the garment of praise in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God is not a man that will have too much trouble. Amen. Jesus Christ is not carrying any burden, and he said, bring your burden to him, he will carry it. Amen. So we don't go to human beings, we go to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ has no problem, no load to carry. He himself bore our sicknesses, he carried our pain. That's what the Bible says, and by his stripes we are healed. Amen. In Jesus' name, the Bible says God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all they that were oppressed of the devil. I pray for your healing today, for the restoration of your soul in the name of Jesus Christ. Be healed, brothers and sisters, be made whole in Jesus' name. I pray that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Cover yourself with the blood of Jesus. I cover all my subscribers with the blood of Jesus Christ. I call you all blessed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Thank you in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Shalom.